We are discussing chapter number 15, which is waves. We are going to discuss about waves. What is a wave? Any vibratory disturbance in a medium that is carrying energy from one point, say this point, to another point, without any actual movement of the medium. The medium is not moving, only the energy is passed on by the medium particles. So this is a generation of wave. You can say there are three types of waves: mechanical wave, electromagnetic wave, and matter wave. As the name is suggesting, mechanics, so this wave, these wave, they follow Newton law of mechanics and Newton law of motion. These waves, they require material medium for their propagation, which are called as mechanical wave, like the sound waves, water waves. Electromagnetic waves, or we also call them as EM waves, produced because of the electromagnetic, you can say, the phenomenas and criterias. And these waves, they do not require any material medium for their propagation. These are called electromagnetic waves, like the light waves, the radio waves. Then matter wave, we know matter, which can exist in solid, liquid, gas, any body, anything which is called as a matter. So these waves are commonly used in modern technology. They are unfamiliar to us, and you will find it associated, or people generally say it is associated with the inner part of the constituents, like the electron, proton, fundamental particles basically. What are the nature of waves? We have transverse wave, longitudinal wave. So a wave which is transverse wave, in which the particles, they vibrate at right angles to the direction of propagation. So this is the direction of propagation, and this is the you can say the movement, or the lateral movement with respect to the propagation. So the particle, they move right angle to the direction of propagation. These are called as transverse wave. This is an example, a crust and troughs. You can see the upper part is crest and the lower, the ditch part, is the trough. So these waves travel in the form of crest and troughs. Then we have longitudinal wave. What are longitudinal wave? A wave in which the particle of the movement, the medium, vibrate in the same direction. That means the particle also vibrate in the similar direction in which the wave are going to vibrate, or wave are going to travel or propagate. So this is called longitudinal wave. As you see here, this is a spring. So this is a compression. These springs are, you know, they are very close to each other and they are far apart as with respect to this. So these are rarefactions. So longitudinal waves, they form rarefaction and compression, and the transfer wave, they form crest and troughs. So this longitudinal wave, they travel in the form of compressions and rarefactions. There are various important terms which are related with the wave motion. First is the wavelength, which is represented by lambda. And this is nothing but the nearest difference, or two nearest points in which a wave have the same phase. You can say the difference or the distance between two crests, two troughs, two crests and two troughs, and two nodes, two antinodes, all these are wavelength. Then we have time period, that is the time taken to complete one vibration. This is called as time period. If you take 1 by t, it becomes frequency. So frequency is the number of vibration completed in 1 second, which is actually the inversion of this time period. So frequency is given by 1 by t, 1 by time period. The SI unit of this frequency is hertz, H-E-R-T-H, T-Z, hertz. Now the velocity, or wave velocity, we can write it as V. So the distance traveled by a wave in 1 second, the distance traveled by a wave in 1 second is called the velocity of the wave. And there is a relationship between the velocity, frequency and wavelength, that is V equal to F lambda. Velocity is equal to frequency into wavelength. Frequency can be written as nu also. You'll see in the book, it will be written in the form of nu. Because V and nu matches so much, that is why we have written F here. What is the particle velocity? Particle velocity, the velocity of the particle, which is actually moving here and there, that is moving at the same position of vibrating. You can say simple harmonic motion it is doing. This is called the particle velocity. This is given by dy by dt. Sound waves, of these mechanical waves, all the mechanical waves occurs in nature. So the most important is the longitudinal wave in medium. Usually the air we see, these are called the sound waves. So this is one of the kind of mechanical waves. So there are three types basically: infrasonic, audible and ultrasonic. So let us have a range from 0 to 20 hertz, 20 to 20,000 hertz, and then 20,000 hertz and above. So 0 to 20, if the frequency is here, we call them as infrasonic waves. From 20 to 20,000, that is 20 kilohertz. We also, the audible range of human being is 20 hertz to 20k, that is 20,000 hertz, and these are called as audible waves. When we go above this 20 kilohertz, these are known as ultrasonic waves. The waves which has frequency higher than 20,000 hertz or 20 kilohertz, these are ultrasonic waves. So sound waves, as we said, that these are mechanical longitudinal waves, so they travel in rarefactions and compression. They require medium for their propagation, and sound wave cannot propagate through vacuum. If we have Vs, the speed of sound waves in solid, Vi in liquid, and Vg in gases, you can also write it as L. So this is the relationship that sound waves, they are traveling faster in solid, then liquid, then in the last in gas. The sound waves, that is longitudinal wave, they can reflect, they can refract, they can interfere, and they can diffract as well, but they cannot be polarized, because only transverse wave like this can be polarized. Velocity of longitudinal wave is given by v equal to under root e by rho in any medium. This e is the elasticity of the medium, and this rho is the density of that medium. So this is the velocity of longitudinal waves. Newton formula. According to Newton, the propagation of this longitudinal wave in gas is an isothermal. Isothermal means temperature remaining constant. Isothermal process. So the velocity of longitudinal wave or a sound wave in gas would be v equal to under root et by rho. And what is this? This is p. Et, why we are writing e sub t? Because of the isothermal. So this et is the isothermal coefficient of volume elasticity, and this is equal to the pressure. So et, isothermal elasticity, equal to the pressure of the gas. Then we have Laplace correction. Laplace said that the propagation of longitudinal wave is an adiabatic process. That is, the pressure should be constant. So the velocity of longitudinal sound wave in gas should be ES, that is gamma p by rho. This ES is the adiabatic coefficient of the volume elasticity, and this is given by ES is given by gamma p. P is of course the pressure. What are the factors which are affecting velocity of longitudinal or sound wave? First is the effect of pressure. So the formula we know, the velocity of sound in a gas, V is given by under root P by rho. And we know PV equal to RT if the number of moles are 1. For 1 mole, PV equal to RT. So for this P, we can write RT by M, RT by V. And when we put it here, the V and rho will make M. We know that mass is equal to volume into density. So volume and density makes M. So this formula becomes under root RT by M. So this P by rho remains constant at constant temperature. If this T is constant, the mass will remain constant, and R is the universal gas constant. So this P by rho remains constant at constant temperature. This has to be constant. Temperature has to be constant. So there is no effect of pressure on velocity of longitudinal wave. Then the effect of temperature, the velocity of longitudinal wave in a gas, again this when we talk about the gas or you can say effect of temperature, when we with respect to velocity of longitudinal wave in a gas, we say V equal to under root gamma P by rho. Again this P can be This P can be written as RT by V, and RT by V, V and rho makes mass, so RT by M. So you see, velocity is directly proportional to under root of T, because R and M are constant. So you can say V is directly proportional to the under root of the temperature. So you can write V1 by V2 equal to under root T1 by T2 equal to, you can carry on with various velocity with respect to temperature. So velocity of sound is in gas is directly proportional to the square of its absolute temperature, that is the temperature at Kelvin scale. So if V0 and Vt, these are velocity of air at say 0 degree centigrade and T degree centigrade. So Vt becomes V0 1 plus T by 273 to the power half, that is root, under root. And we need to solve this, taking this half into consideration, a root into consideration. Vt is equal to V0 plus 0.61t. You can also do it by the expansion of Meyer-Mills theorem. What is the effect of density? The velocity of sound in gaseous medium V is inversely proportional to the under root of density. So we can write V1 by V2. So rho 1 goes here, V2 for V2, rho 2 goes here. When V2 are velocity, rho 1, rho 2 are the density. So velocity of sound in gas is inversely proportional to the square root of the density. Inversely proportional to square root of density. And the effect of humidity, the velocity of sound, it increases with increase in the humidity. Velocity will increase with increase in the humidity. Shock waves, the speed of a body in air is greater than the speed of sound, and this is also known as the supersonic speed. So such a body will leave behind very clearly seen region of disturbance, which is spread continuously on the back of it, or on the release of the gases, you can say. So such a disturbance is called a shock wave. The speed of transverse motion, whenever we are talking about a transverse motion, if we talk about an unstretched string, this V is equal to under root T by M. This T is nothing but the tension, because we are talking about the stretched string, so there has to be some tension. And M is the mass per unit length. We also call it as mu, which is mass per unit length. How can we write this? The speed of transverse wave now in solid will be under root rho by this eta by rho. Eta is what? V is equal to under root eta by rho. Eta is what? Eta is the modulus of rigidity and rho is the density of solid. Plane progressive simple harmonic wave. What is the equation of a plane progressive simple harmonic wave? It is given by y equal to a sine 2 pi t by capital T minus x by lambda, where this y is the displacement, a is the amplitude, this lambda is the wavelength, capital T is the time period, x is the distance of particle from the origin, and this v or u is the velocity. These two are exactly equal. They are just being changed, their formula has been changed, and they are exactly similar. Important relation related to equation of progressive wave velocity is given by the coefficient of T by coefficient of x. What if you compare the equation of wave, then we see that wave velocity is given by omega by k. This k is simply 2 by lambda, so we'll use this k, which is the wave number, you can say. It is given by 2 pi by lambda. This is called the propagation constant of wave motion. Wavelength is given by lambda, is given by 2 pi by k. T is given by 2 pi by omega, and eta is given by omega by 2 pi. So the phase of vibration in the angle of sine in equation, if you see the progressive wave equation, it is given by phi. Phi is nothing but 2 pi T by T minus x by lambda. And there is a relationship between, and these all has come from equating with this relationship. And this is a relationship between the phase difference and path difference. Delta phi equal to 2 pi by lambda delta x. Or you can also write, this is the phase difference and path difference relation. And this is phase difference and time difference relationship. So delta phi is given by 2 pi by lambda delta x. Delta phi is given by 2 pi by t delta t. So these are two relationship. Echo. The repetition of sound, which is caused by reflection of sound waves, this is called echo. You might have heard echo in your room, means a big room, like auditorium, Or you might have also encountered the echo while you are on a hill and you are sounding your name, you are echoing. So this sound persists on ear for 0.1 second. So the minimum distance from sound which is reflecting surface to hear an echo is 16.5, above which only you are able to listen to the echo. If first echo to be heard after say this first second, T1 second, the second after say some T2 second, the third echo will be heard after T1 plus T2 second. Superposition of wave. So when we have one wave, another wave, what is the final wave? There is a combination of these two or multiple. I can have one more. So combination of these waves are superposition of waves. So two or more progressive waves, they can travel simultaneously in the medium without affecting the motion of one another. So there is a resultant displacement. The resultant displacement of each particle of a medium at any instance is equal to the vector sum of the displacement produced by two waves separately. So one and the other. So what we are trying to say here is the resultant displacement of each particle will be the vector sum of displacement of this one and this one waves separately. So this is called the principle of superposition. Interference. When two waves, say we have two waves and they have same frequency. The same frequency is important. Traveling in a medium simultaneously in the same direction. They are going in the same direction. So there is a principle of superposition. That means the particle will move according to this vector sum of combination of these two. So the resultant intensity at any point of the medium is different from the sum intensity of the two waves. They will be different. So at some point the intensity will be quite large with respect to other points. And at some points it will be very low, very small. And this phenomena is called the interference of waves. In interference of wave, there can be constructive interference and destructive interference. When constructive interference, that is the phase difference has to be, or between these two waves, the phase difference has to be the even multiple of n, that is 0, 2 pi, 4 pi, like this. And for destructive interference, the phase difference of two wave will be the odd multiple of pi here, that is 2n plus 1 by 2 into pi, like you can say this, and this is 2n pi. So the maximum amplitude here in this case, if we have two waves A and B, and the amplitude of first is A, second is B, A plus B is the maximum amplitude. In this case, the maximum, because there will be a destructive interference. So A minus B, if you subtract this is the difference of component of amplitude, and this is your minimum amplitude. The intensity here is directly proportional to amplitude square. In this case also, the amplitude is given by A plus B, so A plus B whole square. In this case, A minus B amplitude, so A minus B whole square. Intensity is directly proportional to A minus B whole square. In this case, A plus B whole square in this case. So in general, what we see, the amplitude is given by under root A square plus B square plus 2AB cos phi. If you take the example of vibrating tuning fork, when it is rotated near ear, it will produce loud sound and a silence due to the constructive and destructive interference. Beats. So when two sounds of nearly equal frequency, this is very important. Two sounds nearly equal frequency. So the frequency has to be very, very close. They are produced simultaneously, then the intensity of the resultant sound produced by their in superposition, because they are very near, they are having same frequency, so they are going to be resultant sound of, because of this superposition, it will be increased and decreased alternatively with time. So there is a rise and fall of intensity, and this rise and fall of intensity of sound because of this scenario is called the beats. So the number of maxima and minima heard in 1 second is also known as beats frequency. So what is the number of beats heard per second? If you say n1 and n2, this is the difference of frequency of two waves. n1 minus n2 will be the number of beats heard per second. And the maximum amplitude will be a1 plus a2. Both a, take a1 from one, a2 from the other one. So maximum amplitude will be a1 plus a2. The maximum intensity, we know that this is directly proportional to the maximum amplitude whole square. So a1 plus a2 whole square will be the maximum intensity. And for the loudness, the time interval will be 1 by n1 minus n2, 2 by n minus n2, 3 by n1 minus n2, and likewise.